What is going on, friend? Sean Don coming back with a technical analysis. Here we have Tony Summers. He's low key a grip and rip veteran. I think I helped him out. It was either during the pandemic or just before. I can't recall. It's so long ago. 2 years. Who knows? But either way, Tony's at the University of Michigan now, and I imagine they just started their off season, so he's looking for a little extra input. So. He signed up for the technical coaching package, which means he gets to send me videos often as he wants. You get started off with an in-depth technical analysis just like this. So, if anybody else out there would like some off-season technical help, hit up your boy, go to gripandrip.co and sign up for any one of my packages, all right? Let's get into it. Let's take a look at Tony's throw. He is a silhouette in this video, but he is a real human being, believe it or not. Yeah, it's been cool to watch Tony's progress since he's gone to Michigan. His technique is really shaping up. He's been dominating the Instagram Reels game. Millions of views. A lot more active left side than I recall. Some rhythm tension in the winds. Controlling that head a little bit better than I recall. So, one more time through and we will break it down. You can really see that left hip working, dude. I love it. Okay. Break it down. Break it down. Break it down. All right. Into the winds. Left-handed, so I'm bound to mess up left and right side stuff, but you know what I'm talking about, and I usually try to catch myself. But in the winds, three winds. Personally, three winds aren't for me. I did it for a whole season. I don't see the point in it personally. Maybe you like the tension. Maybe you like the setup. Whatever it is, I respect it. Do your thing, Tony. But I think personally, for my own rhythm, my own style of throwing hammer, two winds makes sense. Slow first wind, strong second wind, and then enter, let the tension build. It's easy. When I think you start with three, you kind of hit top speed at the end of the second wind. And then it's like, all right, well, how do I keep building from there? And so it's kind of hit or miss as to what might happen. Do you continue to build? Do you break tension? Do you break posture? Whatever it might be. Kind of step back, hips up, reaching really long out behind you, in front of you, all around you. It's great. Big step up. Out to your left, hips forward. A little extreme here, but I dig it. You know, it looks like you have good flow with the hammer, and that's kind of what I think something like this can help. I used to do something like this, and then I tried to keep myself more stable, and now I kind of find that the middle ground is the best. You want a little bit of fluctuation and flow with the hips. You don't want to be stiff like a board. But then you can see you're reaching out decently well. I think you could try to reach out to your left a little bit more towards 90 or 270, depending on how you like to talk about left-handed hammer degrees, but let's call it 90 just to keep it simple. But to reach out to 90 a little bit more with that left arm in the entry, that way you can get the hands forward a little bit more, up and out away from you a little bit more, set up a nice long orbit. And otherwise your left side, sorry, your right side, I already messed it up 3 minutes into the video, but your right side is pretty stable. Your entry, shoulder, knee, foot, toe, all that stuff, pretty stable there. You can see your head leads it a little bit. And then could set direction a little bit more. So just push backwards, rotate this whole right side backwards towards 180 just a little bit more. Push through the inside of this right foot just a little bit more. Otherwise, entry looks pretty solid. You're pretty patient. You could have this left hip chase the hands around a little bit more. It's just a little bit behind, but it's pretty solid. And then, so the big thing I think for you, and it's kind of always been this way as well, but it's getting better, is getting a little bit more separation into this first turn. So, ball goes out to the sector. What I want you to kind of think about is to just kind of sweep this right hip under and be as tight and controlled and get it underneath you as fast as possible. That doesn't mean rush the hammer, but you need to still move with it. I'm kind of contradicting myself at this point, but you do need to get a little bit more separation with this right hip, with your hips and your shoulders, and kind of think about, like, it's like at this point right here, you should kind of think about kind of reaching and putting this right hip down. Because otherwise you see you land and there's a little bit of separation. Your feet come all the way back around, and this kind of comes back to finding a little bit of direction in the entry with that right side. But getting a little more separation, getting a little bit more direction in this first turn might help a little bit, get that right hip underneath you. Posture isn't bad. It's just not great where the hips could be more underneath. You could be more centered. You want your hips maybe more like literally right between your feet. That would be dope. A little bit more positive shin angle in this left foot. If you can see shin angle being from the foot up to the shin, or just comparing it to the ground, pretty neutral. All right, it's better than it being negative, I guess. That's a very arbitrary term, but you want this knee out a little bit more over the toe. That allows the hips to come more underneath you. Keep your chest tall, and you just have a little bit more power and stability in this first catch. Otherwise, you still get a little bit of that left side pulling in this right side. I already messed that up again. Your right side pulling, left side kind of pausing here. So just got to focus on smoothing things out, turning with the hammer, keeping this left foot turning. I think if you did a lot of drills this summer, just basic turn drills focused on turning that left foot with the hammer, that would help. But otherwise, yeah, because you can see it pauses a little bit here. The left leg, sorry, the right leg opens up. The left leg pauses, and it finally starts to turn towards the end of double support. But you're ending up back on this left side towards the end of double support, which is good. I like that. And then you can see a very similar thing that I've noticed a lot lately. Like I said, this left, or sorry, this right knee is very stiff. All right, when the right knee is very stiff, it's hard to get those hips under. You get that separation, like I said, that I've talked about before earlier in the throw. So at this point, think about dropping. And like I know you've had was it knee or hip injuries in the past. Think about kind of dropping this right knee towards 180. Once again, doing a lot of slow stick drills, stuff like that can focus on getting that separation, or even doing like wraparounds, stuff like that into turns can help out a lot. But otherwise, you can see this right knee just kind of stiff, doesn't really drop a little bit, doesn't really flex a little bit until the end of single support. So if you got this left knee to drop a little, or sorry, right knee to drop a little bit more forwards, same thing, get that separation, get that left hip more underneath you, which you do. Hips are kind of starting to get in between the feet. Getting some separation, posture is pretty solid, and then a little bit of pulling, of dragging, if you will, but it's back over this left side, which is fine with me. Shoulders are down, it's not super up in the shoulders. A little bit tight. I think hands could be out away from the body a little bit more. But then you're kind of you can see there is a little bit of tension up in the shoulders, so try to relax those shoulders forwards and let it out. Tuck the hips under, posterior pelvic tilt helps it hips up into the ball. Otherwise, same sort of thing as before, not as dramatic. Yeah, see that left foot doesn't pause as much. Turn with the hammer a little bit more. Now you're going to get more separation going into the next turn. Hips underneath you. You're drifting a little bit down this left sector line, but hips are more underneath you. Good catch position here. Like I said, now you're settling back over this left hip a little bit more. You can see more tension coming up though. If it wasn't a silhouette, I think you'd probably see there's a little bit of bend in this left arm. You can see the tension up in the right shoulder. Hips getting up into it better though. And then right leg, same sort of thing as before. Stiff. Stiff through here, and then you got to be a little bit softer on it. Drop down, rotate, twist the hips, get them underneath you. Where you can see you're getting, it looks like there's good direction, good tension here. You can feel the ball going towards 180. You're catching, you're stronger, you have more reactivity, so you can really plow through the finish, hips up into it, really solid finish. So you've made some good changes, and I think, yeah, after maybe a few months of technical input from your bully, maybe things will get a lot better. Just gotta stay focused and iron these things out. Like I said, slow, easy turns, discipline, discipline, discipline. All right. So once more, lines, not a huge deal. Like I said, set up that entry a little bit better. Right side direction, left side with it, left hip up underneath you. Get a little bit more separation the first turn by, like I said, softer right knee. I think that'll help a lot in all the turns. And then from there, things should get better. Hips more underneath you, more separation. Hips more underneath you, more separation. And then patience, 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 and then. Yeah, but either way, you're looking strong, you're looking sturdy. So you got a good foundation to work from, I think. So let me know if you have any questions, Tony, if anybody else out there would like any off-season coaching. head on over to gripandrip.co, all right? So, thank you for watching. Until next time, Sean Don, signing off.